And you prefer Ed as opposed to Edwin or Eddie. You just like Ed.
Ed. Yeah, that's okay. That's what I'm known as.
It's a grand old name.
Oh, yeah.
Well, when your first name officially is Vernon, that's like a boy named Sue.
Ah.
You know, what do you have to do with a name like Vernon? You have to be either the toughest kid in the neighborhood or the fastest. So I go by Ed.
Okay. And when did you start going by Ed?
No, right from the beginning. My mother, she actually called me Eddie.
Okay.
But it's Ed. Yeah. Anyway.
So growing up, you grew up, and did you? At what age did you start playing the game of hockey?
Oh, we played on the streets. We didn't have skates, you know. This is when you're 6, 7, 8. First time I guess I skated was probably 9 years old. You know, unlike these kids today, they start when they're 3 and 4 when they start to walk. But yeah, about 9 years old started to skate. But we skated, you know, on the ponds whenever we could shovel off. Patch of ice up in Oshawa, Ontario, outside Toronto. So it was, but that's the way we did it then, yeah.
And even today, outside, they had like a rink set up in the parking lot at Sabonics. How fun is that?
Oh, no, that's the kind of thing that we all kind of grew up with. We didn't have the sophisticated sticks and things like they have today, those plastic things. But we didn't have boards. We used to use packed ice. And when we shoveled off a patch of ice, that was our boards. And yeah, and the kids that weren't very active, they got to be goalies. We called them targets.
I was going to ask you. So you didn't play goalie. What were the positions that you enjoyed playing?
Well, I did. When I first started, I was a goalie. Yeah, my first couple of years as a little boy, I was a goalie. But there wasn't enough action, I guess, because the team I played on was so good that they didn't let anybody into our end. So I said, I know, I'll become a defenseman. And I was a defenseman through junior hockey in my early years in the NHL. And then slowly I started to take up into the forward lines, killing penalties, taking face-offs, and chasing the best players from the other team around.
Now, when I talked to Kevin Weeks, who's a good goalie, he was telling me about five-hole. So I think if you play goalie a little bit, then I think it also makes you be a better shooter.
Well,
right? Because then you kind of maybe anticipate the openings?
Yes, and you know, it's interesting that the five-hole really started to become a shooting spot when goalies started to use the butterfly. In the early years, stand-up goalies, and you're hearing more and more about the old-fashioned way of, you know, stand-up goaltenders, where they stood up, played the angles, didn't give up the top of the net like they do when they butterfly. But, yeah, the five-hole was a favorite because a goaltender's locked into that, and there's always going to be a little space. A few of the guys like Mike Bossy and some of the others, they could find it a lot easier than some of us. So, yeah, but they'd make the goalie look a little bad when it went between his knees. So, yeah.
Who are some of your other, I was going to say compadres, some of your other friends that played hockey with you that you still, you know, kind of like reach out to and call?
Yeah, of course, as you get this far in life, and luckily I'm still hanging around, but, you know, I have an alumni with the Bruins and where I started in 1961. So there's still a few of us still around from my early years and my years with the Bruins. And then, of course, I have the alumni group from the Islanders. So I'm blessed that I have two. And so, you know, some of the players from the Bruin days, Orr and Sanderson and Busick, I see them a couple of times a year. Maybe a little more of Orrin Sanderson. They live near each other up on Cape Cod, so I go up and play golf with them. And, of course, here around Long Island, you know, we've got, fewer and fewer, but there's still some of the guys that haven't immigrated totally to Florida yet, but I see them either in Florida or on Long Island at events such as the one we're here with, which is wonderful. You get to see all these great people that left their marks individually and collectively here in the area.
Yeah, it's like the Legends Invitational, which is kind of exciting, right? Because you really are. There's like a list of legends. They're like, who's coming? And like, this one. I said, wow,
well,
right?
It's known. We call it a major.
Okay.
Because of the wonderful people that Troy and his group that put this on, and you would never say no to them.
Right.
But the fact that all these guys recognize what they're trying to do with, you know, with this wonderful event and give a lot of pleasure skating wise, just not just hockey players, figure skaters and so on. So it's a good chance to get to see some people from the past, like that great movie, same time next year. Yeah. Only it's a bunch of guys and girls that get together, and our stories get better as we get older. We know we're perfecting them. So our lies are getting better, and now we're starting to believe them. I really wasn't that good.
No, you are that good. In fact, when I walked up to you today, I reminded you that it was years and years and years ago, there was a local bank, and I got to shoot that commercial with you. And I remember, like, it was, we spent the whole day on the golf course, but we were only on one hole. Yeah. Right? We just kept shooting it over.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, one of the people that I spend a great deal of time with even today was chairman of State Bank of Long Island, which is, of course, now not State Bank anymore. It was bought by Valley National Bank. But anyway, yeah, the people, even from that team on the bank side,
yes.
I see several of them. And as I say, I'm here today and see a great deal of a fellow named Tom O'Brien, who was the chairman. He was the chairman of the bank. So, yeah, that commercial. And I was with that bank for 24 years. So that was another team, you know, a fellow named Tommy Goldrick, who brought me to the bank back in 1988. And, you know, so that was a team. And they were starting a bank. I said, start a bank. He said, well, it's a team. You know, I said, I'm used to teams.
Yes.
And it turned out, to be a team building a bank. And they were very successful at it.
I kind of feel that way about Mr. Pascucci. So Michael Pascucci, I worked with him in 1997, and to be back working with him again in this different kind of way, it's just kind of fun, and it's, as always, wonderful to see you.
Well,
so,
thank you.
Yeah, we're going to have fun today, right? Yeah,
oh,
we're going to raise some money, have some fun. So
yes, that's what we're all here for.
Thank you so much. And is there a favorite hole that you have at Sabonic?
Oh, my gosh.
One you love the best?
Well, I love to hate it. Okay. There's a number 11th hole. It's probably the hardest hole on the golf course, and all the years I've been lucky enough, and I've known Mr. Pascucci a long time, and I've been lucky enough to come out here and play, and I still can't do anything about that 11th hole.
Okay.
If I get a par, I celebrate.
There you go. Well, here, I'm going to rub elbows with you, and maybe that'll bring you a little luck.
Thank you.
So we're hanging out. You know, here we're just having a great time. But if he does well today, I don't know, this elbow, we might have to bronze it. Stay tuned.
Thank you.
It
was great.